Welcome to Fairport Flash, the monthly economic update powered by the Fairport Investment Team. Our team gathers the most recent news, data, and research and distills it into the information most important to you. Let's get started.
Will the next decade become known as the Roaring Twenties 2.0? Hi, and welcome to May's edition of The Flash. My name is Jason Adams, and I'm a portfolio manager on the investment team within Fairport Wealth and Luma Wealth Advisors. I joined Fairport and Luma in March of this year after spending more than 20 years managing portfolios investments at a local firm in Cleveland, Ohio, and I could not be more excited and grateful for the opportunity. From day one, all my expectations have been exceeded in regards to culture, philosophy, leadership, and people. As a native Clevelander and someone that truly loves the region and believes in its potential, to be part of a firm with deep Northeast Ohio roots is important. I've already gained great traction with the investment team, and I can't wait to contribute, help the team on the investment side, and the firm as a whole fulfill its mission of inspiring families. In addition to the excitement I feel on a professional level as I start my next chapter, I feel a great deal of excitement about where we are as a country economically. As a member of the investment team, one of my responsibilities is to monitor economic data, as I've done over the course of my entire career. Let me say, and I don't think it's an overstatement, that the last few months have produced one of the strongest, if not the strongest, set of economic data that I have ever seen. Coincidentally, or perhaps not, I've heard reference to the 1920s a few times over the last several months, both in personal and professional conversations. Interestingly enough, another era in our country's history characterized by exceptional economic growth. It got me thinking, and I couldn't help but wonder, will the 2020s become the Roaring Twenties 2.0? So I decided to educate myself to see if history could provide any lessons to our current investment thinking. I was told long ago that in the investment world, history may not repeat itself, but it certainly rhymes. And my findings reminded me how important it is to always look forward when building investment solutions. Nonetheless, it was an interesting journey into the 1920s, so I thought I would use it as a prism of sorts to illuminate our positions, opinions, and expectations for the current economy and financial assets going forward, compare and contrast the current period with the original Roaring Twenties, and ultimately try and answer the question, will the 2020s become the Roaring Twenties 2.0? So let's go back 100 years. The stage for prosperity and growth was set with a unique confluence of factors. The Allies had won World War I in 1918 with America's help. The world was recovering from the Spanish flu pandemic. Shortly thereafter, women received the right to vote via the 19th Amendment, and over the course of the decade, millions of women entered the workforce. Another interesting parallel as the decades were starting was that all bars and taverns were closed. The reasons were very different. As the Volstead Act, signed into law in January 1920, shut down all watering holes as part of Prohibition, while we all know that restaurants and bars last year were closed in response to the COVID pandemic. Another similarity, that both decades started with recession. Unemployment climbed 12% in 1920, and last year it reached close to 15%. Along with those recessions were significant declines in the stock market, with a 32% decline in 1920 and close to a 60% retrenchment in 2020 as measured by the Dow Jones Industrial Average. The parallels are undeniable. So let's dive into a little bit about what made the 1920s roaring. The national wealth more than doubled during the decade and the economy grew 42%. The U.S. produced almost half the world's output as World War I decimated most of Europe. Soldiers returned home with new perspectives and skills learned in Europe. Mass communication began with the first radio station invented in Pittsburgh in 1920. Within 3 years, there were 500 radio stations across the country, helping fuel rise of the consumer society. For the first time in history, more people were living in cities than on farms. People from coast to coast were buying the same goods due partly to the rise of radio, chain stores, and national advertising campaigns. Inventions of the washing machine and vacuum cleaner increased efficiency and eliminated drudgery. It was estimated that close to 75% of Americans were going to the movie theater on a weekly basis. The airline industry literally took off. The 1925 Kelly Act authorized the post office to use airmail. A year later, the Air Commerce Act authorized commercial airlines. Between 1926 and 1929, the number of people flying on planes increased from just 6,000 to 173,000. And then perhaps most importantly for the decade's growth was the Model T, the first widely affordable automobile costing just $300. Coupled with easy credit from banks, close to 26 million cars were on the road by the end of the decade. The government spent $1 billion on roads, bridges, and traffic lights, and an economy of automobiles was born. Gas stations, service centers, motels, restaurants, insurance, bankings, and the loans required to buy the cars all rode on the back of the Model T. So you have culturally mass communications, the freedom to go where you wanted, when you wanted with the automobile, the rights of women to vote, and increased participation of women in the workforce gave rise to nouveau ideas, a feeling of independence and new ways of thought. Charles Lindbergh captured the country's imagination with the first transatlantic flight, as did the Graf Zeppelin, the first airship to fly around the world. Flappers cut their hair and shortened their dresses. Dance crazes like the Charleston and cakewalk swept the nation along with jazz bands and hundreds of millions of records for phonographs. Wide use of electricity powered the economy. The underground economy related to prohibition gave rise to speakeasies and powerful gangsters like Al Capone. Margin debt and other financial innovations contributed to the prosperity. By the end of the decade, the national wealth had doubled, the Dow was up 400%, the top income tax bracket fell from 73% to 24%, and prosperity and freedom permeated society. Sounds like a great time to be alive. So, will the 2020s become the decade known as the Roaring Twenties 2.0? Despite the many parallels already discussed and several other analogous relationships, we could talk about social media being the new radio. We could talk about the inventions of 5G wireless communications, advancements in artificial intelligence and genomics, electric vehicles and blockchain technology as the new washing machine, dishwasher, and vacuum cleaner. There's even bipartisan support for an infrastructure bill currently circling through Congress. Despite all those similarities and sort of the unique confluence of factors, I think there's too many significant differences to really compare the two decades from an economic and financial market point of view. Demographics, the monetary system, completely different. Fiscal policies, tax policies, technology, and globalization are just a few of the significant differences between the two decades. That said, I do believe, as I previously mentioned, there is a unique confluence of factors that could make the 2020s a historically prosperous period in our country's history, just like we had in 1920. Never before have we had the combination of monetary stimulus, fiscal stimulus, excess savings, cash on the sidelines at businesses, and pent-up demand ready to be released as the world reopens from the global pandemic. I mentioned earlier the unprecedented strength in economic data. Whether it's ISM surveys, company surveys, vehicle sales, corporate earnings, housing prices, new business applications, I could go on and on. But when we take it all together, it paints a picture of an economy poised for economic liftoff. Lots of good things happen when a $21 trillion economy gets rolling. There are risks, as there always are. I would put at the top of that list rising interest rates, increases in inflation, which we're already starting to see, the twin deficits, higher taxes, high valuations across basically all financial markets, high levels of investor sentiment, and obviously COVID and the successful containment and distribution of vaccines to treat this on a global scale and keep it under control. So, a well-designed financial plan powered by a diversified portfolio allocated across multiple asset classes, industries, and geography remains imperative. But for someone whose job it is to follow the economy on a day-to-day basis, I can't help but feel a tremendous amount of optimism for what the next decade holds. We continue to recommend overweighting portfolios to equities to capitalize on the accelerating economy. Similarly, we want to underweight bonds in anticipation of higher interest rates and look to alternative strategies and assets for further diversification. to finally try to answer the question, will the 2020s become known as the Roaring 20s 2.0? Chances are slim, based on the significant systemic differences I discussed earlier. But I would not be surprised if come 100 years from now, in 2120, people look back on this next 5 to 10 year period as a time that was indeed a great time to be alive, just like the 1920s. So if you have any additional questions or would like to discuss our outlook in more detail, please contact your Fairport Wealth and Luma Wealth advisor. Thank you for listening. Have a great day. All the best. Thank you.
Fairport is a group of investment professionals registered with Hightower Securities, LLC, a member of FINRA and SIPC, and with Hightower Advisors, LLC, a registered investment advisor with the SEC. Securities are offered through Hightower Securities, LLC. Advisory services are offered through Hightower Advisors, LLC. This is not an offer to buy or sell securities. No investment process is free of risk, and there's no guarantee that the investment process or the investment opportunities referenced herein will be profitable. Past performance is not indicative of current or future performance and is not a guarantee. The investment opportunities referenced herein may not be suitable for all investors. All data and information referenced herein are from sources believed to be reliable. Any opinion, news, research, analysis, prices, or other information contained in the research is provided as a general market commentary. It does not constitute as investment advice. Fairport and Hightower shall not be in any way liable for claims and make no express or implied representations or warranties as to the accuracy or completeness of the data and other information, or for statements and errors contained in or omissions from the obtained data and information referenced herein. The data and information are provided as of the date referenced. Such data and information are subject to change without notice. This document was created for informational purposes only. The opinions expressed are solely those of Fairport and do not represent those of Hightower Advisors, LLC, or any of its affiliates.